Hey guys, it's Sarah, and I am here to do my November book haul revisit video. So these are all the books that I hauled in the month of November for the past 2 years, and I will tell you what I hauled, where I am with them, have I read them yet, have I not read them, and then I will also talk about whether I unhauled them already and give you kind of my final statistics at the end. Okay, so for 2015, I had quite a few books that I got at Goodwill, and then I also had gone to a library sale during that time, so I had some books from that as well. The first two books that I hauled are both part of a series, and I got them both at Goodwill. And the first one is Sabriel, and then I also got A Porson by Garth Nix, and this is book number 1 and number 3, I believe, so I don't have book number 2 yet, so I have not started this book. But this is a fantasy series, and that's really all I know. I've heard very good things, but that's literally all I know about it. And I saw it at Goodwill for a good price, so I went ahead and picked up these two. And I have not read them yet. Next three are the same situation. I had heard about this series, and I was really interested in it. And then I found 3 of those books at Goodwill, so I went ahead and picked them up. So I got part of the Dublin Murder Squad series by Tana French. The first one is In the Woods. The second one is The Likeness. And then the 4th one is Broken Harbor. I do currently have all of the books except for the newest one, which I believe is called The Trespasser, but I got them other places. So just last November though, or 2 Novembers ago, oh my gosh, 2015 is 2 Novembers ago, I did pick up these 3 at Goodwill. Haven't read them yet. And then I bought 4 books at a book sale from the library. And the first one was Sleeping Arrangements by Madeline Wickham. I actually read this one earlier this year and I really enjoyed it. Madeline Wickham is also the author under the name Sophie Kinsella. So Madeline Wickham is her real name and Sophie Kinsella is her pen name. And I really enjoyed this one. It was cute. I did unhaul it since then so that someone else can enjoy it as well. So I enjoyed it. It was good. I think I gave it 4 stars. I enjoyed it more than I thought I was going to, but those are not books that I feel like I want to keep on my shelves, so I have unhauled it. And then the next 3 I also got at the library sale, and the first one is Cutting for Stone by Abraham Verghese. And this is a book that I've heard of so much over the years and just heard really, really good things about it, and I found this really great copy, and it was only 25 cents, so I jumped on it. Haven't read it yet. Next one is The Paris Wife by Paula McLean, and I have not read this yet, but I'm going to be reading it sometime in the next year because this is on my birthday reading project list because someone did recommend this book to me specifically. So I'm going to be reading it. I just haven't quite got there yet, but this is a historical fiction that is following, I believe, the first wife of Ernest Hemingway. I think he had multiple wives, but I've heard very, very good things about it. And the last book that I got in 2015 was also from the library sale, and that is The Clan of the Cave Bear by Jean M. Owl. And this is the first book in the Earth's Children series, which is very, very popular and very beloved, and I've heard very, very good things about it. My mother and my sister have both read this and said that I would love it as well. So I have it, I just haven't read it yet. And I picked up this edition because I love it. It's just an oversized paperback, it's huge, it's floppy, it's fantastic, and I love it. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to 2016. I had quite a big haul, and ironically, it was also library books. So I believe November is a good month for library book sales. I'm actually gonna be going to one next week. So yeah, November's a good library book sale month around here at least. The first one that I hauled though, it was one that I won from a giveaway from another channel, and that is The Serpent King, and this is written by Jeff Zentner. I have not read this yet. However, when I first hauled it, I thought it was like a science fiction type of book because The Serpent King, I don't know why I thought that because I did not read the synopsis. No, this is a contemporary. So, and I've heard very good things about it. And yeah, I just haven't read it yet, but eventually I will. Okay, so these next two I found at Goodwill. The first one is The White Princess by Philippa Gregory. This is just a Philippa Gregory book that I found. It was in really good condition. I'm kind of collecting them as I find them because I want to get into her. I've really been getting into historical fiction and she is very big in that genre. Haven't read anything by her yet though. I'm ready to. I'm ready to. I have the first one in mind that I know I want to start with and I just haven't started it yet. It's not this one, but I did pick it up at Goodwill, so I hauled it. Okay, this next one I picked up on a whim. I never heard of this author. I never heard of this book. I know a lot about him now, though. And that is The Red Breast by Joe Nesbo. I now know that this is part of his Harry Hole detective series, and this is like book number 6 or 7 or something. It's not number one. Number one is The Bat, which I'm trying to get my hands on so I can start reading that, because I've heard very, very good things about this series. And there is a movie coming out soon called The Snowman, and that is based on one of the books that is in that series called The Snowman. And I would like to get into it. I just have to get my hands on the first book. I just haven't quite gotten to that point yet. But I picked this up on a whim, just thought it'd be fun to kind of branch out and read some authors I had never read before. I like the cover of this book. I like the premise of it. Come to find out, it's in the middle of a series. So it's fine. Okay, these next few are library sale books. And the first one is Love Anthony by Lisa Genova. Haven't read this one still. I'm still very interested in it, though. I like the premise of it. It is about a boy who is autistic and his mother helping him in life because he needs a lot of help. And then I believe he passes away, and it's, but you see the aftermath of it because he's not fully gone. So I'm still really interested in it. I just haven't read it yet. Okay, another library sale and another author I have not read yet, but I was interested in it when I picked it up, and that is Philip Margolin. This is a bind-up, so there's two books in one here, and the first one is Gone But Not Forgotten in Wild Justice. And I believe Wild Justice is the start of a series, and then Gone But Not Forgotten is a standalone. I have to double check on that, but one of them is like that. And yeah, I've never heard of Philip Margolin before. And then after I picked this up, I started hearing a little bit more about him, and people were saying they really enjoyed his work. So again, haven't read it yet, but I have it ready to go. Okay, next one, another library one, Marion Bradley Zimmer, and this is The Inheritor. I haven't read this yet. I probably should have read this in October, honestly. I believe it's kind of a ghost spooky type of story, so I kind of missed the boat on that one. We're kind of past the spooky stuff now. But yeah, I haven't read it yet. So, yep. Okay, this next one. Another library one. Another author I'd never heard of, but the premise of this book sounded very interesting. I hauled it, and then someone very kindly let me know that's number two in a trilogy. Great. I really wish they would write that on books. But I got Dominion by Randy Alcorn. Since I have gotten this book, and actually I do have the other two now, I slowly kind of collected them, so I have the whole trilogy that I can read, but after getting this book, I've heard more and more about Randy Alcorn, and another one of his books is actually on my birthday reading list because someone recommended it to me, so I will be getting into him for sure. But I picked this up, it's big and chunky and oversized, and I loved it. I was like, ooh, I really like that edition of the whatever book this is. And then I read the description and really thought it was intriguing. And yep, come to find out, it's number two in the trilogy. But I have since bought number one and number three. So I do have the whole trilogy now. I just haven't started it yet. Okay, so the next one is The Help by Catherine Stockett. I have read this book. I read it before I bought it. I read this quite a few years ago as part of our book club, and I absolutely loved this book. I did not have a copy of it, though, because I think I read it from the library when I first read it, and then I just never picked up a physical copy. But when I saw this at the library sale, it was $1. It's a perfect condition hardback. I was like, there's no way I'm not going to put that on my shelves, because it is one of the best books I've ever read. Adore this book. Okay, the next one is another library one, and that is The Light Between Oceans by M.L. Stedman. I have still not read this book, haven't seen the movie. Yep, no excuses though, it's short. Like, I could get through this really quickly. I just have to be in the mood for it, and I just don't know that I am right now. So, I don't know, we'll see. And I was about to say another library one, but all the rest of these are library sale books, so just they're all the rest of them are library sale. All right, so I got The Ape House, and this is by Sarah Gruen. Sarah Gruen wrote one of my favorite books of all time, Water for Elephants. I absolutely love that book. This one's about apes, so I don't know. We'll see. That's all I really know about it. But it, again, it's a short one, so I'm interested still. Okay, the next one is Freedom by Jonathan Franzen. Still haven't read this book. I still don't know what it's about, but I'm interested in him as an author to give him a try and see what I think. And it's a good copy, so yep, it's still sitting unread. And the next one is Never Let You Go by Erin Healy, and this one I still have not read yet, but I've heard is a thriller and a suspense novel, so I'm always down for those. I'm always willing to give any thriller or suspense book a chance and see what I think. I just haven't done it yet. And the next one is Sea Escape, and this is written by Lynn Griffin. I don't remember the premise of this. I know it's a contemporary, and I want to say it follows a woman who is finding out more about her family through her mother, but her mother is declining health-wise, so she's kind of learning some things before her mother goes. But seriously, this was a cover by. I did not care what it was about. This seashell, I can't. It is so gorgeous, and I'm obsessed with it. And the last one that I hauled is a book that I have unhauled since, and I didn't even read it, but it was just one of those, I don't know why I bought this book. I'm probably never going to read it, and even if I do, I'm probably not going to be all that impressed. And that is No Way to Treat a First Lady, and I don't remember who wrote this book. I got rid of it recently, though. It was one of those things where I was going through my shelves and saying, okay, I need to just kind of clear some things out and be realistic about what I am and am not going to read. And this one didn't make the cut. So yeah, I unhauled it, but I didn't read it. Okay, so my final stats for the last two November hauls is that I hauled a total of 23 books. I have read two of them. I've unhauled two of them. And then I still have 20 on my shelf that I have not read yet. So those are crappy, crap, crap numbers, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm still, like, as I'm collecting these books, I'm still really interested in reading all of them. So that's good. That's a good sign. Okay, that's going to be it for me today. Please leave me comments down below. Let me know if you've read any of the books I talked about and what you thought. Let me know if you picked up any really good gems at your local libraries, if they do sales and stuff. If you don't know if they do sales, I would ask the question because most public libraries do have some sort of sale either annually or biannually or, you know, something like that, because libraries get so many donations from the public and you just never know what you're going to find. And it's a really great way to also support your library. It's very, very important. All right, leave me those comments and I will talk to you guys again soon. Have a great day. Bye.